Today, we're looking at LED bar lights. They're supposed to give improved light distribution, reducing that hot spot in the center. I'll test this grow light from Maxsisun. We'll see how hanging height impacts coverage, as well as light intensity. Maxsisun provided me a sample for testing, and I've taken over 800 PPFD spot readings with my Apogee SQ-520 sensor. It comes with the basic hanging hardware. A simple design, no daisy chaining, no power switches, but we do have a dimmer knob, and we'll see how accurate that is. And to do that, we need light. The MG3000 uses Samsung diodes. These are the LM281B+ versions, not the 301Bs or the 301Hs. It's not from a third-party lab, but I found Maxsisun's reports to be reliable and trustworthy. For the MG3000, the PPF is 687 micromoles, and the efficacy is nearly 2.4 micromoles per joule. Note, this was pulling 289 watts during the test, and my tests confirmed that power at the wall. With a PPF of 687, that breaks down to 76.4 PPF per square foot in a 3x3 tent, perfect for high light flowering on a 12-hour light cycle. Over a 4x4 area, you'll achieve 43 PPF per square foot, which would be good for veg growth. How's the light spread, though? What placement achieves the best results? I was disappointed that Maxsisun's online maps were all at 18 inches. The manual shows this 24-inch map. I definitely had to check 12 inches as well. First, let's compare my 18-inch PPFD readings to Maxsisun's. This is the same grid spacing and sensor position. My average PPFD was 97% of Maxsisun's, and that's expected, since my sensor's not designed to pick up far red photons. What surprised me was that my readings show less variance from center to corner. With this map format, the outer readings are still 3 inches from the edge. I wanted to see the PPFD map over a true 3x3 area, so I realigned my grid to get edge-to-edge readings with even more data points. Comparing the two map formats, you see the average PPFD dropped slightly since my corner readings are further from the center. Working from the average PPFD, you can see how each spot deviates either above or below the average. My weakest spot in the corner was only 68% of the average, but the center reading was 35% brighter. What happens when the light's lowered? Here are standard spot readings at 12 inches, and here are the edge-to-edge ones. Compared to 18 inches, the average PPFD goes up by 4%. Look at the center-to-corner readings. At its lowest, the PPFD dropped to 51% in the corners, while the center showed an 80% boost. So, in a 3x3 tent, a 12-inch hanging height gives a slight boost in output, but at the cost of uniformity. Honestly, I expected to see a bigger boost in intensity at 12 inches. I wondered what the drop-off would be at 24 inches. Here, we can see my edge-to-edge readings. The average PPFD was 5% lower than at 18 inches, but look how uniform the light levels are. The lows to highs range from 81% to 118% of the average. Depending on your cultivation methods, like Sea of Green, this might be a good height option. So, comparing all three distances, you can see the range in light levels at the canopy and the uniformity. If you want to squeeze every bit of production you can, 12-inch height would be good for a few plants in the center. For the most uniform coverage, 24 inches is good, although there's that dip in efficiency. Of course, 18 inches is a good middle ground. When in doubt, use that as your starting point. If you're interested in seeing the light spread without any reflective walls, here are those charts. There's the 12-inch height. Here's the default 18 inches. And this is at 24 inches. What happens as you start dimming the MG3000? If you're trying to be precise, either use a kilowatt meter for your power at the wall or a light meter for your target brightness at the canopy. I did take some dimmed readings at the 12-inch hanging height, shooting for 3/4, 1/2, and 1/3 intensity. I found a fairly predictable drop-off in light as the power dropped off. it was a linear reduction. Any percentage of power reduction will result in a comparable light reduction. And this held true from the center to the corners. So, what are my overall impressions of the MG3000 LED grow light? It would easily replace a 400 watt HPS and might give an older single-ended 600 watt HPS a run for its money. It won't match the performance of a quality double-ended 600 watt system though. Compared to T5 fluorescent lights, this light would match the output of 12 4-foot bulbs. That's a 350 watt power savings. Even if you dimmed the MG3000 to 100 watts and used it to replace a 4-bulb fluorescent system, you could see a payback in 2 years' time. In the realm of LEDs, this bar light style expands the diode footprint over a larger area, which translates into more even coverage versus quantum style boards. However, if you're looking for uniformity over 9 square feet, 18 inches is a minimum height, and 24 would be even better with just a slight drop in light intensity. At a 12-hour light cycle, you'll be looking at a DLI of 31. That'll work well at ambient CO2 levels for super even coverage over autoflowers in a sea of green. You could run this at 24 inches, giving you a DLI of 44 on an 18.6 cycle. So yes, I'd recommend it as a good balance between performance and value. I hope this info helps you out. If you decide to go for the MG3000, you can support my channel by clicking on the link in the description.